So good morning to everybody. Welcome in today's science and technology class. We will continue with information and communication technology. Okay. In last class we had done with good morning Tarun. In last class we had done with some of the important topics like quantum computing kya hota hai. Okay. And we will continue with information communication technology and then we will start energy. Okay. So first topic will do with blockchain technology. So what is blockchain technology? Every year you can see two, three questions from IT. Basically they ask question which is most important or burning issues. So blockchain technology, artificial intelligence, quantum computing, this year all these topics are very, very important, both for prelims and mains examination. So we'll see blockchain technology because recently our country also said that we have to also go digital currency, that is like cryptocurrency. Okay, so we'll discuss what is cryptocurrency, bitcoins, all these things. So before going to start bitcoins, to understand what is bitcoin, what is cryptocurrency, we have to understand what is blockchain. And blockchain technology is one of the important you can say advanced version of IT. So first of all, what is blockchain technology? So you see there is one word is given called block. So basically block is a, you can say it's a digital information. How you understand block? Block is a digital information. And this digital information connected with many blocks. Okay. And this is the number of square you see are connected with each other by your nodes. This is called a nodes that connect between two blocks. And what is this block? Block is basically a digital information. When we send any information to a receiver, that is sent in the form of block. And one block, suppose I will give the name of block A. This is the block A. This is the block C. This is the block D. And this is the block D. So block B is different from block A. Block C is different from block B. And block D is different from block C. Each and every time when we send a signal, our information, our digital information contain some keyword, okay? And that key means basically signify the authorization. Means if anyone who receive a block B from A, the person who are sending A, sending a digital information to B, when he receive information, that signifying that this is authentic information. And that is in the form of digital signature. Okay, a single block contain a digital signature. You can say a digital signature means that provide a authenticity. So it is like a transformation of information that will be transferred from one place to another place without any fear to crack. Anyone can crack it, or anyone can it is a fully contain a cryptography. Okay, cryptography, it is a process where encryption is more secure. Your data is more secure. Okay, so basic idea of blockchain technology is it is a structure that store transactional records. Okay, also known as block of the public in several databases known as chain. Okay, so this is our chain that connect in network connected through a peer-to-peer nodes. Typically, this storage is referred to as digital ledger. Now you all have work on Google Docs. You all have work on Google Sheet like Excel or MS Word. So suppose you have a friend of 8 to 10 friend you have, and one of your friend create one Google Sheet and share with you all 8 to 10 friends. And when you share a Google Sheet, a Google Docs, everybody can work on it at the same time. Everybody can bring a changes. Okay, are you work on Google Sheet or not? गूगल शीट क्या होता है, जैसे कि जीमेल से हम गूगल शीट में गूगल डॉक्स में जाते हैं, यू आर शेयरिंग अ डाटा, यू आर शेयरिंग अ गूगल शीट, एक्सेल शीट और एमएस वर्ड शीट विद योर फ्रेंड्स. सो इफ यू आर ब्रिंग एनी चेंज, योर फ्रेंड कैन इजिली सी इट, दैट एनीवन कैन ब्रिंग अ चेंज. आप जिससे जिससे गूगल शीट को शेयर किए वो सारे उस पे चेंज कर सकते हैं. सिमिलरली योर गूगल शीट इज योर लेजर. ओके, एंड व्हेन यू शेयर दिस लेजर विद योर फ्रेंड्स, इट इज कॉल्ड अ डिजिटल लेजर्स. Okay, it has become a digital ledger. Your one Google sheet, a one Excel sheet in a Google page, that is called ledger. And when you share with this, your friend, it is called digital ledgers. But The concept is same here in blockchain technology. Only difference is that once you send signals, when you send information as digital information, it can't be edited. Okay, it can't be edited by anyone. Everybody can see your page. Okay, everybody can see your page. Whatever things is given, everybody can see, but no one can bring any edit on it. It can only bring by a person who have a private key. So blockchain technology basically work on two principle. One is called public key and other one is called private key. So what is public key? Public key basically, you imagine yourself that in your school there is a one notice board. Okay, a notice board. In notice board there is a one gap is there. Those who have want to give any information to the principal or any teacher, they just write it on your paper and just put in the wooden box. But who have a right to see all the information? Those person who have a private key, those person who have a key of this wooden box, he can open it and see the all the information. So that is the concept of blockchain technology, where a concept explain that how our digital information must be secure and easily transfer without any paperwork, without any government interference, without any third party interference. Means this is the concept of peer to peer transformation of information. Okay, so every transaction in this ledger is authorized by digital signature. Okay, digital signature is something which provide authenticity, that the person who send this digital information has authentic, means that will be received, okay, of the owner, which authenticate the transaction and safeguard it from tampering, okay, without any means delay, without any fraud and term. Hence the information on the digital ledger contain highly secure. Okay, in simple word, digital ledgers like Google spreadsheet, जैसा मैंने आपको बताया गूगल स्प्रेडशीट होता क्या है, लाइक यू वर्क ऑन गूगल डॉक्स, लाइक डॉक्यूमेंट वर्ड फाइल और एक्सेल शीट, यू शेयर विद योर फ्रेंड्स, इट्स लाइक अ डिजिटल लेजर. इट्स शेयर्ड अमंग द न्यूमरस कंप्यूटर इन अ नेटवर्क इन विच ट्रांजेक्शन रिकॉर्ड्स आर स्टोर्ड बेस्ड ऑन एक्चुअल परचेजेस. द फैसिनेटिंग एंगल इज दैट एनीबॉडी कैन सी द डाटा बट दे कांट करप्ट इट. ओके, सो दिस इज अ मोर सिक्योर टेक्नोलॉजी वेयर वी keep our information transferred to everybody and that our information is more and more secure. For example, when you're doing shopping on Amazon or Flipkart, what you will do? You will just open your category. Suppose you want to purchase mobile phone, you will open a mobile category. You'll see, will select your favorite mobile, favorite company, your favorite mobile, whatever models you want to purchase. Every time you putting the information that I am selecting mobile iPhone, I will select S7, S8, and every time you when you select, it means information you are transacting it. Means ऐसा तो नहीं होता है ना कि अगर आप मोबाइल में आईफोन ओपन किए जब आगे जाते जाते आप देख रहे हो कि आप सैमसंग में आ गए, ऐसा तो नहीं है. Nobody can corrupt your, nobody can edit your information. So that is the example of blockchain technology. Okay? Now why blockchain technology nowadays is more popular? Okay, why most all the world over they are means switching from fiat currency. Fiat currency basically we are using money. Our money we are daily we are using money like a currency note. That is called fiat currency that can exchange with anyone. Why from fiat currency all over the world, even India wants to go for digital currency. Okay. अभी का जो सिचुएशन उसमें डिजिटल करेंसी होना ही बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, बिकॉज सच टाइप ऑफ वायरस स्प्रेड बाय आल्सो बाय विद द हेल्प ऑफ करेंसी नोट. ओके, सो व्हाई ब्लॉकचेन टेक्नोलॉजी इज मोर पॉपुलर नाउडेज? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट इज अ हाईली सिक्योर, नोबडी कैन मींस एडिट इट और नोबडी कैन करप्ट इट. सो ब्लॉकचेन टेक्नोलॉजी यूज डिजिटल सिग्नेचर. डिजिटल सिग्नेचर कॉन्सेप्ट आपको ये समझना है यहाँ पर, इट इज प्रोवाइड अ ऑथेंटिसिटी दैट information sent by a person जहाँ से information origin हुआ है, that origin that a person is authenticated and those who accept your information will be accept without any fear. Okay, signature features to conduct fraud free transaction, making it impossible to corrupt or change the data of an individual by other users without a specific digital signature. So this is the one advantage, that's why it is more popular all over the world. because of highly secure. Second one is decentralized system. Okay, decentralized system means where a power is given to everybody. That is called decentralized system. And what is centralized means all the power is given central positions. So conventionally, you need to approval of regulatory authority like government or bank or transaction. However, blockchain transactions are done with the mutual consent of user, resulting in smoother, safer and faster transaction. So centralization mein kya hota hai ki you have to take approval from the central government. Suppose you want to take a loan from any foreign institutions, you have to first apply a form to RBI, and then RBI will give you information that this much amount of money you can borrow from international institutions or any foreign banks. So this is a process which delay your transactions, but this is not happen within blockchain technology, where no need to take approval from the central authority. A peer to peer, that is a person who is dealing with the same person, means other person, they can just involve in the transaction, and this is in a very less time they can share the information and transaction will be completed. Automation capability, it means that it is a programmable and can generate systematic action, events and payment automatically when the criteria of the trigger are met. So it is not required that means you have to always, every time you have to put the information. This is a automation, basically artificial intelligence, where you can put your data, a transaction will be completed when a receiver will find that this is a digital signature that provide authenticity of the users. Then because of all these three, it is more popular all over the world. Now, what are the benefit of blockchain technologies? Blockchain technology ka benefit kya hai ki as a public ledger system, blockchain records and validate each and every transaction made, which make it secure and reliable. Okay, secure bhi hai, reliable bhi hai. All the transaction made are authorized by miners. Who is called miners here? Miners who every time generate a digital signature, who every time generate a blocks. Okay, that is called a miner. A mining activity. It's like a mining activity. The concept of mining, whatever we know in other field, like mining extraction of minerals. So those person who engage in mining activity, that called a miners, who generate a block, who send a signal, a digital signature to every time, they are called miners, which makes the transaction immutable and prevent it from threat of hacking. So that will be secure from hackers also. Okay, nobody can corrupt it, nobody can crack it, your encryption code. That is the concept of cryptography. Okay, so that's why cryptocurrency is more popular all over the world. People are trusted on cryptocurrency, that this is a more secure transaction, it will not create any problem. Yes sir, Akshay, we are doing any transaction, online transaction, whether we are doing with you are purchasing anything from Amazon, Flipkart, or online purchasing, or you are doing a Paytm, that everything is work on blockchain technology. Okay, so blockchain technology discard the need of any third party or central authority for peer-to-peer transaction. It is allowed decentralization of the technology, but in case of banking transaction, we are doing a banking transaction, we are transferring online money. Okay, from suppose you want to give a transaction, you want to give some money to your friend, but from you have account in Bank of India and you want to send money to SBI account before. So you will go to your Paytm, you just put the money, you put the account number, and then you put pay button, then a money will send to your friend's account. But before going to friend's account, it will be approval by given by the central body. There is a requirement of central body, but in blockchain technology and cryptocurrency, there is no approval from the central authority. That will be a peer-to-peer without any interference of third party. It allows decentralization of technology. Basically, a centralization ka nahi hai isme, means central will be not participate, a third party will not participate under this transaction. Okay, so there is a lot of application of blockchain technology, and most important one is the healthcare. Healthcare is basically blockchain technology mein healthcare mein kaise kaam karega. It is creating a secure and flexible ecosystem for exchanging electronic health records. Okay, health records like Digi Lockers. You know what is Digi Lockers? Digi Lockers basically a platform where users who sign in with the Digi Lockers, they will give a facility to store their documents digitally and more safer. Okay, suppose your school certificate, your medical certificate, you have some important documents, land records, or your property documents. If you want to store, we are storing hard copy to somewhere. Okay, so Digi Locker is allow you that user that they can store information digitally, and this Digi Locker is will be linked with your Aadhaar number, Aadhaar card. Okay, every person have their Aadhaar number, so this Digi Locker will be linked with your Aadhaar number, and whatever information you have means like a digital you want to save here, your 10 class matric certificate, 12th class certificate, your graduation certificate result, a land property, whatever documents, important valid documents, you can store it digitally and you can access from anywhere. So this is one of the advantage of the blockchain technology. Okay, this technology could be also make the space more transparent by creating provinces of for critical drugs, blood, organ, etc. In addition, by putting all medical license on a blockchain, fraudulent doctor can be prevented from practicing. This has happened with many part of your country. Those person who just make a fraud certificate and they started to practice in rural areas, they are started giving medicine to persons without have any degree. So it's like a fraud. Okay, it's like a fraud. So that will be a blockchain. If all the universities will apply this blockchain technology, they can keep all these automation capability means without any approval given. Okay, without any means every time you will not require to put your information. Okay, Sadhika, every time no required to put information, that is called automation capability. It itself know what the next process required. Okay, that is called automation capability. So this is happened with the blockchain technology in healthcare. Another application you see here in education purpose, what the it will help in education. So student records, faculty records, and educational certificate can be maintained with the application of blockchain technology. The record of all the students who had qualified this year, who had how many students are taken a degree from this year, faculty records, their education, higher education, what type of subject they have already studied. Okay, everything will be stored in a blockchain technology. It can also simply certificate attestation and verification. Like we are doing attestation by visiting to some other persons approval, take approval for taking admission in any other institutions. So it could be even transform the manner in which the policy for educational inclusion is framed by bringing in base uniformity in the tracking of national metrics. So government's program like a national skill development program, a government program like a science and technology development program, governments want to do provide education to each and every section of a society and provide a science and technology research and development in different fields. So that will become more easier if we apply blockchain technology in this type of fields. In agriculture, basically blockchain technology can be used to increase the transparency, reduce complexity and cost of food-based value chains by enabling trustworthy provenance and traceability from farmer to consumers. Okay, so that will become an ENAM, that is the electronic national agriculture market. That is the connection of the farmer directly to the mandi. Okay, a digital information given to each and every farmer. That what is the rate of the what is the price, current price of rice in mandi? A different price, because the middleman, when a middleman present between the farmer and the mandi, they manipulate the prices. They say to farmer that this is the actual price, they are asking here. So that type of fraudulent will be reduces if they we will introduce blockchain technology in agriculture. It will also include the use of blockchain technology record and manage agriculture land record as well as agriculture insurance, crop insurance, farmer insurance program. Okay, everything government's Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, ओके प्रधानमंत्री मीन्स वट एवर द स्कीम लॉन्च बाई द गवर्नमेंट फॉर इंश्योरेंस प्रोग्राम ऑफ द फार्मर दैट विल बी एवरीथिंग विल बी पॉसिबल एंड दैट विल बी रिकॉर्डेड इन अ सेफ मैनर दैट हेल्प्स गवर्नमेंट टू ट्रैक द रिकॉर्ड ऑफ द फार्मर्स एंड हाउ मच अमाउंट दे रिक्वायर्ड इन ईच ईयर्स दैट विल बी हेल्प इन ब्लॉकचेन टेक्नोलॉजी. सिविल रजिस्ट्रेशन दैट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू रिकॉर्ड, जैसे मैंने डिजिटल लॉकर के बारे में बताया था कि यू कैन जस्ट रजिस्टर वाइटल इवेंट सच एज बर्थ एंड डेथ सर्टिफिकेट ऑन ब्लॉकचेन. दिस कैन हेल्प अ सिटीजन रिकॉर्ड टेम्पर प्रूफ रेजिलियंट सिक्योर एंड प्राइवेट दस प्रोवाइडिंग वाइड रेंजिंग ऑफ बेनिफिट फॉर अ वैरायटी ऑफ स्टेक होल्डर्स. सो बिजनेस मॉडल्स ओके लाइक वट एवर दे आर डीलिंग विद बिजनेस अप्रूवल MOU दे आर साइंड विद डिफरेंट कंपनीज दैट विल बी यू कैन बेसिकली कीप सेफ अंडर दिस ब्लॉकचेन टेक्नोलॉजी. In defense, basically, it is a maintenance of efficiently maintain of track information regarding defense infrastructure and computers. The defense infrastructure, what new defense required, okay, equipments required, new type of missiles, any technology required for the improvement of our defense or security purpose. So that will be helping defense stage. In governance, for good governance, like blockchain technology can be used to check government corruption, increase efficiency and transparency. That is the example of good governance. Linking file and data movement between departments through blockchain would increase the visibility into process, ensure that data file move forward in real time. So basically this is happen in official work and government sector that means when we send a file from one ministry to another ministry or one department to another department, they suppose this is a hierarchy of level. ओके हम लोग पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन पढ़े थे एंड इफ अ पर्सन हु इज वर्किंग अ पर्सन ए वांट टू सेंड अ फाइल टू ई बट बी इज सुपीरियर टू ए सी इज सुपीरियर टू बी एंड डी इज सुपीरियर टू सी एंड द फाइल विल बी रन फ्रॉम ए टू बी बी टू सी डी एंड देन इट विल रीचेस टू ई सो दैट क्रिएट अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम कंज्यूमिंग. इन ब्लॉकचेन टेक्नोलॉजी इन रियल टाइम A directly sent to E file without any third interference. So that will be helps to government policy and implementation of program in a more faster manner. Again, in banking and financial sector, blockchain technology will help. It can be used in money transfer, record keeping, and other backend function in the bank. So money record transfer, record keeping of the whether it will be also helps public sector bank or commercial bank to know. How many accounts are going to become NPA, non-performing assets? Okay, whether there is a planning for giving more loan to the this type of person whose account become NPA, so that type of information will be given to the is very easily known by the banking sectors by the help of blockchain technology. Okay, is it clear? Now we'll talk about cryptocurrency. ब्लॉकचेन टेक्नोलॉजी में हम लोगों ने क्या देखा कि इट इज लाइक अ ऑथेंटिक होता है, रिलायबल होता है, ऑटोमेशन होता है. सो दिस आर द सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट फीचर ऑफ द ब्लॉकचेन टेक्नोलॉजी दैट मीन्स आवर ट्रांजेक्शन बिकम सिक्योर. ओके सो क्रिप्टो करेंसी मीन्स क्या होता है, इट इज बेसिकली इट वर्क ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ब्लॉकचेन टेक्नोलॉजी. ठीक है, क्रिप्टो करेंसी क्या है, इट इज अ डिजिटल और वर्चुअल करेंसी दैट इज सिक्योर्ड बाई क्रिप्टोग्राफी विच मेक इट नियरली इम्पॉसिबल टू काउंटरफिट और डबल स्पेंड. Like our fiat currency is counterfeit by many persons, so we have a fake currency notes in our country. That is illegal movement of fake currency, and that fake currency, if it will come in market, that destroyed the trust people on the government. They will not able to trust on the government because of more and more fake currency. So cryptocurrency basically it is a digital currency. Okay, it's a virtual currency. It is not like a fiat currency. It's not visible. You can touch it. Okay, it's like a programming that will be present and that helps in a transaction. Like we are doing a transaction in day to day life. Yeah, if you want to purchase milk, bread, you are giving currency to the shopkeeper. Similarly, you can do the transaction, similar transaction by the help of digital currency or virtual currency. But only thing is that the person must be trust on it. Okay, you must be understand, you must be as much educated to understand what is cryptocurrency. Okay, so cryptocurrency basically it is not be counterfeit by a third party. Many cryptocurrency are decentralized network based on blockchain technology. Okay, as a distributed ledger enforced by a डिस्परेट नेटवर्क ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स. सो व्हाट इज अ डिफाइनिंग फीचर ऑफ क्रिप्टो करेंसी इज दैट दे आर जनरली नॉट इशू बाई अ सेंट्रल अथॉरिटी. लाइक इन आवर कंट्री आरबीआई इशू ईच एंड एवरी लोन. आरबीआई विल डिसाइड दैट मीन्स 500 मीन्स करेंसी नोट विल बी देयर. वी हैव अ 2000 करेंसी नोट. If RBI want to introduce 3000 currency note, that is controlled by the RBI. RBI means basically they printed limited amount of money. That much of money they printed, that is means sufficient to run all the businesses in our country. If more money will be printed by RBI, then it will be causes inflation in our country. Okay, it basically like it decreases the value of rupee if more money will be printed by the RBI. It means everything is controlled by the RBI here, central bank. But blockchain technology, cryptocurrency is not controlled by central authority. It is just a peer-to-peer means transfer, or it depend on the demand and supply. They theoretically immune from the government interference or manipulation. So government interference is not here. A central authority will not participate in cryptocurrency. Okay, and that only depend on the miners who generate this digital currency, a digital signature. Cryptocurrency can be sent directly between two parties, the use of private and public keys. As I told you that private and public keys, same thing. This transfer can be done with minimal processing fee, allowing user to avoid the steep fee charged by the traditional or financial institutions. Okay, so suppose if you want to transfer 10 lakh rupees from one bank to another bank, so you have to pay some fee to the central bank that how much you are means transferring this amount of money to the another bank, or you are transferring this amount of money to another thing. So you have to pay extra fee like a transaction fee. That type of situation is not here cryptocurrencies, because it is immune from, and it is not issued by any central authority. It is only depend on peer to peer transactions. So what are the advantages of using cryptocurrency? Easy access and globally recognized. Okay, it is not Indian cryptocurrency cannot be accepted by USA. USA currency cannot be accepted by India. So this is a globally recognized. Cryptocurrency is readily accessible to all its intended users. It can be used by whoever it wants. Okay, it is decentralized system of currency which can be used and accessed globally. In the case of fiat currency, like we are euro, dollars, or yen, or that is the rupee, may go up or down. Okay, but in the case of cryptocurrency, the market remain worldwide the same. This has happened with this dollar ka ghat gaya, value ghat gaya. Trade jaise ghata, the dollars ka value ghat gaya. Indian rupees ho gaya, aapko leke uska devalue ho gaya. Okay, like devalue ho gaya government. This is a devalue. When a government decreases the value of Indian rupee in the front of basket of foreign currency, okay, that is called depreciation of rupee. Depreciation of rupee basically means a value of rupee decreases in front of US dollar because of demand and supply, and because of we are importing more and more items. So that's why if we have import more items as compared to the export, so our current account deficit, you know what is current account deficit? That is the difference between your whatever we are importing and whatever we are exporting. If we import more amount as compared to export, it means we are whatever we have foreign exchange reserve. Okay, हमारे पास जितना भी foreign exchange reserve है, we have a dollar. Okay, 356 billion dollar that is present in our foreign exchange reserve, and that foreign exchange we are keeping as a surplus money for doing a transaction. When we import oil from other country, so we are paying in a foreign exchange, not paying in a rupee, we are paying in dollars. So that foreign exchange, but when import is become larger, our foreign exchange reserve money decreases. In that case, current account deficit will be there, and in our value of rupee will be depreciated. It means value of rupee will be decreases, but this is not happen with the cryptocurrency. At least cryptocurrency is secure from this type of up and down situation that is happening worldwide. Okay, quick and easy payments, no need to take approval from central bank, no need to check what is the status of this money, whether this money will be accepted worldwide or not. Okay, this is the, you know, IMF everybody know about IMF, International Monetary Fund, and IMF have your special drawing rights, SDR. Some of the five currency are there in SDR, like dollar, euro, yen, Chinese currency is there. Okay, so this type of five currency, which is globally accepted currency, anyone can accept this amount. Dollar can anyone, any country can do, ready to do transaction in dollar, because dollar is accepted worldwide. And but very limited country in the world who can accept Indian rupee for transaction purpose, because Indian rupee is not globally accepted by everybody. So this is the happen. But in cryptocurrency, it is not. It is quick and easy payment without any delay in such type of inquiry or such type of things to know whether it will be accepted by globally or not. It is a quick transaction process. It takes hardly a few minutes to initiate a transaction. You have no obligation to disclose and share your personal details unless the details of crypto wallet. Okay, only the crypto wallet, basically how much, just like your wallet, you are keeping money in your wallet. So similarly, crypto wallet, how much you have a cryptocurrency in your wallet. Okay, only the payer and the receiver will get to know about the payment and transaction, and it's completely secured. So nobody will come and investigate like this has happened with the money laundering cases, and those person who are engaged in black money or doing any money laundering activity, if they are doing any transaction, high amount of transaction, if they can do so, this can be easily known by a central authority, easily known by a enforcement directorate, ED, that look in about the foreign exchange currency whatever we are doing transaction in foreign exchange or foreign currency. So enforcement directorate can easily known. So this is not known by if you are doing a lot of currency, means a lot of transaction done by between two persons. So it will completely secure. Nobody will going to know, understand, and nobody will going to inquire how much you money your transaction have done with this party or not. The simplicity and advantage of anonymous dealing are one of the advantages that are making cryptocurrency more popular these days. Okay. Now, what are the another facility to faster settlement? Okay, faster settlement like real RTGS and NEFT payment method. You need to wait for getting your payment processing if you are doing your transaction using cryptocurrency. Okay, you no need to wait it. Paying based on blockchain, cryptocurrency work on peer-to-peer algorithm, and the payment settlement get complete flawlessly almost immediately. So this is cryptocurrency is a private and secured. More private, cybercrime has become a global threat nowadays. You all know very well. Okay, and doing online financial transaction has become extremely risk. Tied to risk, identify theft, phishing, unwanted tracking of the regulatory body, non-transparency in the online payment system. So this is how new type of threats like phishing is the one activity. They like SMS giving or phone calls given, and they are asking about the important banking details, and some of the person also give their details without knowing whether it is just like a fraud call or whatever call, and all the means money in their account is completely removed without the user information. So that type of cryptocurrency transaction is more secure in this type of transaction that will be done under cryptocurrency. It facilitates e-commerce trade like electronic commerce. So basically where we are doing trade in Amazon, Flipkart, okay, many online websites are there where we're doing online purchasing. It is a global currency, and there is no restriction of using paying by this global currency, which is easier and convenient for business and shopping portals. Okay, if the ultimate aim of an e-commerce portal is business, cryptocurrency transaction can simply facilitate that. If e-commerce is the ultimate of global business, cryptocurrency can be global currency for facilitating the business worldwide. So all, as this is accepted by worldwide, so we can say that cryptocurrency accepted by worldwide, so transaction will be done in a more safer manner. So another one is free from risk for identifying theft. Identifying theft is one of the biggest risks of the online transaction, but with the blockchain integration in cryptocurrency, the risk of identifying theft is not prevent at all. Okay, while doing payment by using cryptocurrency, you can keep your personal information secret, and that is the reason the risk of identifying the theft get completely minimized here. So online transaction, you are doing online transaction. When you are doing an online transaction, your bank keep all the records. Okay, suppose you are visited some foreign country, US, and you are doing some transaction, you are paying hotel bills, you are paying your restaurant bills, you are paying with the movie theater bills. So whatever you are doing transaction in US, all your transaction is recorded by the central bank. So if you have a illegal money, if you have a black money, then question will be may arise in future that from where you earn such money, and you have to answer the question. If the CBI asks you a question, can you tell me this much amount of money you are spending in such country, from where you get such money? But in case of cryptocurrency, you can say that it is a completely immune, and nobody can see how much transaction you have done and how much and where you have done this transaction. So that's why it is called a completely minimized here. Now there is, as you see, some of the examples are there. There are some disadvantages of cryptocurrencies also. Like, it can be difficult to understand. Okay, in the blockchain technology, it is still one of the emerging technology. Okay, and nobody will understand. Everybody will not understand about the digital currency. Trust, there is a lack of trust first on engaging such type of activity in a cryptocurrency. Uncertainty and volatility, basically basically what happened that a cryptocurrency value, as I told you, that it remain the same all over the world, but there is uncertainty what will happen. Is the digital currency something, there will be some corruption if the software is corrupted, if we have no internet facility, if we have no any digital facility, then how we will do in engage such type of transaction. So that type of voluntary uncertainty is there, it's still not accepted by all. Okay, if you are engaged in cryptocurrency, it doesn't mean that you are doing a business with a third party, that they also doing a cryptocurrency business in cryptocurrency. So that will be not accepted by all. No way to reserve the payment, okay, reverse the payment. Okay, basically, if you have done a transaction, then no way to reverse your payment. This has happened with the fiat currency. If you done a payment, then if you want to return back, then we can return receive our money. But this is not happened with the cryptocurrency. Once the transaction is completed, that will be a final transaction. Okay. Now we'll see the types of cryptocurrency. The most famous type of cryptocurrency is Bitcoin. Okay, Bitcoin. सबसे फेमस है अभी तक का एंड स्टिल रिमेन्स मोस्ट पॉपुलर एंड मोस्ट वैल्यूएबल. ठीक है, टुडे देयर आर थाउजेंड्स ऑफ अल्टरनेट क्रिप्टोकरेंसी इन वेरियस फंक्शंस एंड स्पेसिफिकेशन. बिटकॉइन रन ऑन ब्लॉकचेन टेक्नोलॉजी, डिसेंट्रलाइज्ड लेजर. द फ्यूचर ऑफ क्रिप्टोकरेंसी इन इंडिया इज बूमिंग एंड ब्राइट. ठीक है, इफ अ पर्सन इज विलिंग टू बाय क्रिप्टोकरेंसी इन इंडिया, देन फॉर द क्रिप्टोकरेंसी इज लीगल इन इंडिया. ठीक है, तो अभी क्रिप्टोकरेंसी का स्टेटस क्या है इंडिया में, वो भी हम लोग देखेंगे, वेदर इंडियन गवर्नमेंट इज एक्सेप्टेड क्रिप्टोकरेंसी और नॉट. ओके, सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज द स्टेटस टाइप्स ऑफ क्रिप्टोकरेंसी इन इंडिया. द इंडियन क्रिप्टोकरेंसी एक्सचेंज हैव फाउंडेड अ फोरम नेम इंडियाज डिजिटल एसेट एंड ब्लॉकचेन फोरम. सो दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट नेम ऑफ द बॉडी, यू कैन अंडरलाइन इट. Okay, Digital Asset and Blockchain Forum, which agree on the stand of exchanges on various issues such as hard forks. Leading from the front, Bitcoin has won a large chunk of market share, like Ethereum, Litecoin, Bitcoin Cash, or slowly joining the cryptocurrency market in India. So we will see whether a cryptocurrency is legal in India or not. See, right now, cryptocurrency is not legal tender in India. Okay, in India, while exchanges are legal, if you are doing exchange with the cryptocurrency, then that are illegal. But doing a business activity by the help of cryptocurrency is not a legal tender. You can't use the cryptocurrency for a transaction. Suppose you want to purchase one flat in Mumbai and you have a cryptocurrency. If you want to do this transaction in cryptocurrency, you want to pay do a payment in like under cryptocurrency, that will be not accepted in India. That is not a legal tender. So legal tender means that will be not accepted by the public, not accepted. That is a issuance authority is given by the central government, and if anything is declared non-legal tender, it means that that will be invalid. Okay, in India, although there is currently a lack of clarity about the tax status of cryptocurrency, the chairman of the Central Board of Direct Taxation has said that anyone who make Bitcoin gains will have to pay tax on them. Okay, so tax clarity nahi tha. So CBDT ke jo chairman to unhone kaha ki if anyone engages in any type of transaction activity with the cryptocurrency, they have must give the taxes. But in April 2018, RBI banned the processing or payment of virtual currency by banks and any regulated financial institution. So 2018 mein RBI aata hai ek important decision se that it should be a completely ban in India, virtual currency completely ban in India. Nobody will be involved in such type of either even in exchange or even any transaction, payment or processing of virtual currency. So totally ban in our country. Now, why RBI had banned this currency in 2018, that is called cryptocurrency. So according to RBI, what RBI said that cryptocurrency are poor unit of account, as demonstrated by their frequent and high fluctuation in value. Like, you know, hot currency, we called as a hot currency, like financial institutional investors, FIIR. Okay, FII, and you know, one is called FDI, foreign direct investment, and one is called FII, means foreign institutional investor. So those who are foreign institutional investors, they invest money in our capital market. So that why it is called a hot currency. That means there is no any surety they will stay in India. They can, if the our capital market process means performance is very poor, they can easily go back to their own home country. Okay, so there is no any surety of foreign institutional investor in our country, but FDI have surety that they will stay. When FDI will come in our country, they bring technology. Okay, they bring employment generation. They also help in economic development of our country. Similarly, a cryptocurrency is nobody know what will be the value. It will be after 2 days, what will the value after 3 days. So its value remains same at the real time. The value of cryptocurrency remains same. Suppose you are doing transaction at 9 a.m. today. So if you are doing transaction with the US company, that time the value of cryptocurrency will be the same in US and India also. Both places have the same value. But what will be the value after 2 hours? So aap wahi transaction 11 baje karoge, so nobody know what will be the value. But at real time, this value will be remain same everywhere, all over the world. Okay, this is the one situation. That's why RBI say it's a poor unit of account. Nobody know it's a how frequency and high fluctuation in value. Another important reason given by RBI, why RBI banned this cryptocurrency in India, they pose several risks, including anti-money laundering and terrorism financing. Okay, so according to RBI said that terrorism activity, like money laundering type of activity, can be more flourish under cryptocurrency method, because no central authority will monitor the transaction. Nobody will monitor transaction. This transaction happen between the two peer groups. They only know the transaction. So very easily this type of money can be a finance for terrorism activity, a purchasing of illegal weapons, financing the Naxalism in our country, or changing white black money into the white money. So most of the cases it can be happen for the state, and liquidity, credit, and operational risk for users. Okay, third important reason given by RBI, he said that on the perspective of consumer issue linked to cryptocurrency, the heightened by the striking paucity of information on their design, use, and operation, and indicator market manipulation. So basically, users cannot understand what will be the market of the cryptocurrency in future, and whether if they are investing in this money, their money will be safe or not. Okay. And last one is, it is possible that business models of commercial bank may be seriously disrupted. So a credit policy set by the banks are not, because most of the people, if they were engaged in cryptocurrency activity, nobody will going to take loan from banking sector, because their all needs are fulfilled by the help of cryptocurrency, all transaction is done by the cryptocurrency. So that types will be a business model of commercial bank may be disrupted, not able to commercial bank not able to earn money. So you know what is the money, what is the main our source of money for the commercial bank? Basically, we are depositing money in banks, that is called saving account. Under saving account, this is not the, this is the liability of the bank, means you can take your money anytime. There is no any confirmation that suppose you are deposited 10,000 rupees in SBI bank account, you have a right to take after 1 hour, after 1 month, okay? But liability is that a bank earned money by giving loan to business partners, okay? Under like they are paying business partners paying them interest, okay, 10% interest, okay? So that interest is the earning of the money, that is the main source of income of the commercial bank. So that will be disrupted completely, okay? Business model of the commercial bank will be completely disrupted, because most of the businessmen, what they will do, they will do, engage in transaction like hell, that will be possible because of the cryptocurrency. Now, when this ban was done by RBI, it was challenged. Okay, there is a filed a case under Supreme Court, and this ban was challenged in by the Internet and Mobile Association of India in the Supreme Court. They challenged this case ban, and they filed a case, and he said that according to him, trading in cryptocurrency was a legitimate business activity. Okay, and that the RBI did not have jurisdiction over it, as this asset could be classified as commodities rather than currency. He said that they filed a Supreme Court, they filed a petition in Supreme Court and said that this is a legitimate business activity. It is not a currency. It is like a commodities. He said, according to him, Internet and Mobile Association of India, he said that cryptocurrency is not a, actually a currency. We are not engaged in a currency. It is like a commodity, something which is digitally framed, and activity is not as illegal as declared by the RBI. Okay. Now, what will Supreme Court came out with a judgment that he said that if lifting should be not completely ban on cryptocurrency, it must be given some privilege. Okay. Now, what will the effect of lifting this ban on cryptocurrency? The lifting of the ban will help in incorporation blockchain technology. Okay. So if RBI completely means allow the people to engage in activity of cryptocurrency, then what will be the benefit of the entire market in our country? So blockchain technology is the underpinning technology behind many cryptocurrency. Okay, it is the main technology, and we already know the advantage of blockchain technology in many fields. It is in a health, education, governance, agriculture field, okay, space, everywhere we know the importance of blockchain technology. Blockchain, which was conceptualized for the verification of anonymous peer-to-peer transaction in Bitcoin, has since been adopted for many other purposes. Okay, it is not only a disadvantage that nobody, a central authority, will not able to guide it, not able to identify the transaction, but it have another advantages also. It create electronic ledgers where every transaction is recorded and is open to verification by many person while maintaining the confidentiality. Okay. It quickly detects fakes and disallow duplicate transactions. That is the main importance. If anyone who have no authority and they, that person engages in such type of activity, that can be easily identified by the blockchain technology. So blockchain technology is the form, the circular part of Industrial Revolution 4. So what is this Industrial Revolution 4? Basically, it include your artificial intelligence, okay, blockchain technology. We already done with the quantum computing in the yesterday class, we have done with the quantum computing, okay, virtual reality, that are the all new technologies we are dealing with nowadays with the under information communication technology. So this all industrial revolution is called four, where everything become digitalized, okay? So that is the blockchain technology, the backbone of industrial revolution four. Without blockchain technology, we are not able to enter in industrial revolution 4, will not able to start industrial revolution in our country. It is also estimated that blockchain will generate 3.1 trillion in new business by 2030. It is a projection by many expert. A financial expert said that in coming future, if country will be engaged in such type of activity, then global output will become 2030 मीन्स 3.1 ट्रिलियन डॉलर। सो सुप्रीम कोर्ट सेड दैट दिस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल एस्पेक्ट आल्सो, व्हाट सुप्रीम कोर्ट सेड दैट द बैन बाय आरबीआई ऑन क्रिप्टो करेंसी सेड दैट सुप्रीम कोर्ट आल्सो हेल्ड दैट द बैन वाज अनकॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल। सुप्रीम कोर्ट कहता है कि जो आरबीआई ने बैन लगाया है क्रिप्टो करेंसी के ऊपर वो अनकॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल है। क्यों अनकॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल है? बिकॉज इट वायोलेशन ऑफ द फ्रीडम ऑफ कैरी ऑन ट्रेड गारंटेड बाय आर्टिकल 19(1) क्लॉज सी ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। ओके, फ्रीडम ऑफ राइट टू इक्वालिटी के बाद आता आर्टिकल 14-18, उसके बाद राइट टू फ्रीडम एंड आता है स्पीच, फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच एंड एक्सप्रेशन, देर इज आर्टिकल 19 एंड आर्टिकल 19 देर आर 6 क्लॉजेज एंड लास्ट क्लॉज से दैट अबाउट इफ यू आर अ सिटीजन ऑफ इंडिया देन यू कैन एंगेज इन एनी ट्रेड ओके एक्टिविटी दैट इज गारंटेड बाई कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया, सो एनी वन कैन एंगेज इन सच टाइप ऑफ ट्रेड। ओके, सो दिस इज अनकॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल। देर इज अ वर्ल्ड वाइड प्रपोजल फॉर सेंट्रल बैंक डिजिटल करेंसी विच वुड अलाउ फॉर मनी टू बी ट्रांसफर बिटवीन यूजर्स विदाउट द इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ थर्ड पार्टी दैट इज कमर्शियल बैंक। अलाउइंग क्रिप्टो करेंसी विल बी एनेबल इंडिया टू बी पार्ट ऑफ द ग्लोबल डील फॉर इंडिया एमिंग टू बी डिजिटल इकोनॉमी पावर हाउस एम्ब्रेसिंग इमर्जिंग टेक्नोलॉजी लाइक क्रिप्टो करेंसी ब्लॉक चेन इज अ मस्ट। सो वी आर मोस्ट ऑफ आवर गवर्नमेंट स्कीम इज इंगेज इन डिजिटल करेंसी ओके डिजिटल इकोनॉमी वे। सो दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट आवर ऑल ट्रांजेक्शन विल बी डन इन अ डिजिटल मैनर। सो इन दैट केस वी हैव टू अडॉप्ट the cryptocurrency and blockchain technology, we have to utilize this type of technology in every field. That is the concern given by the Supreme Court. Is it clear? Understood what is cryptocurrency and blockchain technology? If in mains examination question will come, you can write all these points. Okay, advantages, disadvantages about the cryptocurrency and blockchain technology. Now this is some current affair part, public domain name system. It was in news. So what is public domain name system and domain name system? So recently our Ministry of Electronics and IT is planning to launch public domain name system server for India to provide faster and more secure browsing experience internet users in the country. So maybe in prelims they can ask you what is public domain name system and what is the significance of domain name system. So our Ministry of Electronics and IT said that we will launch a public domain system that will help the internet users in our country they can experience a browsing in more proper manner. This will ensure that citizen data is stored locally and also protect from malware or phishing attacks. So basically protect our citizen from the cyber threats or cyber attacks like malware. Like malware is a, you know what is malware? Malware is a malicious software. Okay, it is like a software program which enter in your computer or mobile phone that hack everything, that known important data and important information from your computer, from your laptop, from your mobile, like your bank account details, your transaction details, your all the important information you are which you store in your mobile, that will be able to known by a hacker. So phishing attacks like of threat calls are given by they are calling you and asking about your payment system, so that type of will be a safe. Okay, now why this type of activity basically happen? The hackers who are watching, keeping eye on each and every transaction, each and every person who are if suppose you are doing searching something on Google, that your information, someone is seeing that, someone is watching you, what you activity is doing. Okay, so by searching a different things on Google or doing transaction, hackers know that this person have some different account, the person have some good amount of money, or them the person have contained some critical information, so they are able to send us malware. It's like a spyware type of viruses towards your mobile phone or towards your laptop by email or anything that can be stored in your laptop and able to know all the important information. So that is the public domain name system. A domain name system, it is a basically it is a phone book of the internet. As you know, we have a phone book where every information is given, every person's telephone number is given. Okay, human access information online through domain names. Web browser interact through internet protocol address. DNS translate domain name to IP address so browser can load internet resources. What is internet protocol? That is the IP address, like your home address. Everybody have their IP address. So then we send a signal to a person. If you know the IP address, then you are able to send a signal to a person. So each device connected to the internet has a unique IP address, which is other machine used to find the device. This is how a domain system. So remember only one thing, that domain name system will help. This is the initiative of the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology to protect the citizen from the ongoing cyber threats that is increases these days, like phishing and malware activities. It will eliminate from human to human memorized IP address. The process of DNS resolution involves covering the host name into a computer friendly IP address. Another name, ICE-DASH and Atithi. It was in news, maybe in prelims. They can ask you a question, very important for 2020 prelims examination. So government recently unveiled two new IT initiatives called ICE-DASH and Atithi. Okay, ICE-DASH and Atithi aayega exam mein. So jab bhi aisa type of question aayega na, so they can ask you a very simple question. Aapko bas itna pata chahiye ki ye IT se initiative hai. Itna bhi pata hai, to aap answer in UPSC में कर लोगे, क्योंकि they can ask you recently ICE-DASH and Atithi was in news. It is associated which of the following field? Maybe they can ask you satellite, new satellite launched by ISRO, new cryptocurrency instituted by Indian government. This can be like a new agreement signed by India and US for defense deal or IT initiative. So remember only this much, that you know, it is initiative of information technology. So what is ICE-DASH? It is a ease of doing business. It is a monitoring dashboard of Indian customs, helping public see to daily custom clearance stamps to import cargo. Okay, so it is a ease of doing business. Ease of doing business, basically, you know, most important factors or criteria that decide ease of doing business successful in any country, that clearance is most important and validation given by a central authority. So here a custom, Indian customs, basically they will keep eye on the different types of clearance that will be given in more digital manner and a very less bit of time. So that is also one of the factor that decide ease of doing business. This dashboard has been developed by the Central Board of Indirect Tax and Custom in a collaboration with National Informatics Center. The basic idea, ICE-DASH will be helps to give clearance in a very short period of time if we are importing any items from other countries. Okay, so that will, when we import any product from other countries, there is a lot of paperwork required. Okay, a person who engages, who importing item from the other country, they have to visited many government offices for clearance that they are able to take this imported items to their business, to their factory. So it required a lot of time. So that's why ICE-DASH will be helps in it helps to give clearance in a very short period of time, and that will be helps in ease of doing business also. What is Atithi? Atithi is basically easy to use mobile app developed by CBIC same for international travelers to file the custom declaration in advance. Okay, so you are present in US and you want to send some item to your country. So you can advance, this is a mobile app that coming month I will going to bring this item from a particular country. So in advance you can file a application that will helps to very easily give receive a clearance from the government. This will facilitate hassle free and faster clearance by customs at the airports and enhance the experience of international tourists and other visitors to the airport with him. So Atithi and ICE-DASH is one of the new initiatives in IT for providing ease of doing business a more successful in our country. Another one is called Wi-Fi calling. What is Wi-Fi calling? Telecom company Bharti Airtel has launched its voice over Wi-Fi service Airtel Wi-Fi calling a first for India. The first time in India launch Wi-Fi calling. Wi-Fi calling is aimed especially for area where cellular network are not strong. Okay, like you are doing WhatsApp video call or WhatsApp audio call. Similarly, we have a Wi-Fi call technology for area where a cellular network are not strong, like high altitude areas, hilly areas, a very different terrain areas, a very dense forest areas. Okay, where a technology and a cellular network is not reachable. It uses high speed internet connection. It is available via broadband to make and receive high definition voice call. So Wi-Fi calling में अगर प्रीलिम्स में क्वेश्चन आता है, इट इज रिसेंटली इट वाज लॉन्च बाय कंपनी भारती एयरटेल. मे बी दे कैन यूज स्टेटमेंट इट इज लॉन्च ऑल ओवर द इंडिया. दैट स्टेटमेंट इज कंप्लीटली रॉन्ग बिकॉज इट इज लॉन्च फॉर एरिया वेयर अ सेलुलर नेटवर्क आर नॉट स्ट्रॉन्ग. ओके, यूजर डोंट हैव टू पे एक्स्ट्रा फॉर दिस कॉल एज इट यूजिंग अ वाईफाई नेटवर्क. दिस इज नॉट मच डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द वॉइस कॉल यूजिंग व्हाट्सएप or any other top messaging platform, but here at a call is from one number to another and not using in app. So this much, whatever we have done today, in both yesterday class we have done with the ICT, information communication technology, along with the current affair, that much is sufficient for 2020 prelims and mains examination. Okay, after prelims examination, I will again start one current affair session for mains purpose only. Those who qualify for prelims, they will attend this session and we will start a mains purpose where we will do all the current affair of from the month of May to September. And that probability of the question will become more in mains examination, in science and technology or in environment. Okay, so revise all these class notes. Okay, that much is no need to go, read extra. ठीक है, इतना पहले कर लेना, AICT से पढ़ लेना. उसके बाद अगर टाइम मिले तो यू कैन सी अनदर इम्पोर्टेंट करंट अफेयर. नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट एनर्जी. ओके, दिस इज अगेन द पार्ट ऑफ योर साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. So energy basically we'll study about a source of energy in our country. Okay, a different varieties of energy. Energy sector, we will see some of the important point, what is energy, and some important fact about the energy condition in our country. So what is energy industry? Energy industries are those industries who involve in the production and sale of energy, including fuel extraction, manufacturing, refining and distribution. Modern society consume large amount of fuel, and energy industry as a crucial part of infrastructure and maintenance society in almost all countries. So this is important to know some of the important data about the India is the world third largest producer and third largest consumer of electricity. Okay, can write in your mains answer writing by introduction part. As per Central Electricity Authority, the national electric grid in India has an installed capacity of 365 gigawatt as on 31st October 2019. So national electric grid total amount of electricity produced in our country is 365 gigawatt on as per 31st October 2019. So for energy sector, you will read this class note along with India yearbook. In India yearbook, there is one chapter called energy. Okay, so that energy chapter is again important for latest data. You will know and important initiative by the central government for in case of renewable source of energy, or what in India government is going to take a strategy to reduce the use of fossil fuels. The renewable energy share in India's total installed capacity 83 gigawatt, which is 21.91%. See, we have at present 21.91%. And when you will read about Paris Agreement declaration, like India nationally determined contribution, where Indian government said that 40% of energy, 40% of energy must be produced from renewable source of energy. But now we have only 21.91% of energy that is produced by the renewable source of energy. The gross electricity consumption in 2018-19 was 1181 kilowatt per person hour, as compared to the world, which is 2064 kilowatt per hour per person per capita. This is the energy consumption per person in our country. Now, India exported means we are exported energy. We producing energy in our country by different source, like we have a renewable source of energy, we have non-renewable source of energy, we are using producing energy by burning a thermal power plant that produce electricity, and we are exporting energy and also importing energy. So like we importing 5,798 million unit of electricity to Nepal, Bangladesh. This information is important for plans point of view. Nepal, Bangladesh and Myanmar, which is 213 million unit more than we import. Okay, from Bhutan during the April-February to period of fiscal year 2016-17, thus making India first time net exporter of electricity. Net exporter of electricity basically means we are exporting more energy as compared to importing energy. So exporting energy to Nepal, Bangladesh, Myanmar, because this is depend on the location. Okay, so we will see Nepal, Bangladesh, exporting Bangladesh have very not as much developed as compared to Indian for production of electricity. That's why we are importing energy to these countries. But while seeing the Bhutan area, there is a rivers like Kali rivers, tributary of Ganga river, that produces a good amount of hydroelectricity. So it is very easy for us to install a hydropower plant in this country, and we are importing energy from electricity from a particular countries. The largest import of India's electricity, importer of India's electricity export in Bangladesh, followed by Nepal and Myanmar. This information important. Maybe they can ask you, arrange the following country in a chronological order who exporting more energy, electric energy from India. Okay. Now, what are the sources of energy? We have, basically we know there are two important sources of energy. We called as a conventional energy, and this is also known as a non-renewable energy source that include your coal, petroleum, natural gas and nuclear power. Okay, and non-conventional energy or renewable energy include your solar energy, wind energy, hydro energy, tidal energy, geothermal energy and biomass energy. So conventional source of energy, that is called natural energy source, which are present in limited quantity and being used for a long time, like fossil fuels. Okay, we are using, they are limited. Maybe in future they will be completely used by human beings. That's why, and this type of energy also emit a very harmful gases in the atmosphere, like carbon dioxide. By burning of fossil fuels, we know emission of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere that causes different problems like global warming and climate change. That causes a different disastrous consequences all over the world we are seeing these days. Now we know the coal. Coal has, India has the fifth largest proven coal reserve in the world. Okay, the first one is US, United States. Okay, it is a primary energy contributor, 54.2% of energy, total energy production. About 80% India's coal deposit are bituminous type. Okay, there are four varieties of coal. One is called anthracite, bituminous, lignite and peat. Okay, so anthracite contain a good amount of coal. Carbon content is 90%. So it is anthracite is the first. This is considered as a very good varieties of coal. But this type of coal found in India in UTs like Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh UT. But limited amount of high amount of coal present, variety of coal, bituminous type of coal present in our country. And it is non-coking grade. Coking coal is basically a type of coal that is used for blast furnace, the burning of, melting of iron and steel. The most important Gondwana coal field in India is located in Damodar Valley region. झरिया, यू नो, झारखंड इज द लार्जेस्ट कोल फील्ड फॉलो बाय रानीगंज, अदर मेजर कोल फील्ड है बोकारो, कारापुर एंड अनदर थिंग्स। सी दिस इज एनर्जी चैप्टर, वेरी मोस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स आर गिवन फैक्चुअल्स और वी हैव डन इन ज्योग्राफी। अंकिता, मनीष, सदिका, सुमिता, सनमोन एंड तरुण, this is I want to tell you that these are some of the important information you will read and you can understand it. There is no any things to understand. Okay, aap log isko pad loge, agar ye file upload kar denge to, that is just about the factual things, what is solar energy, wind energy. Okay, isme kuch zyada hai nahi, hum log sara kuch pad chuke hain. I will start tomorrow biotechnology. That is the last topic. Okay, so हम इसको अपलोड कर देंगे, आप इसको पढ़ लेना, दैट वी ऑलरेडी कवर इन एनसीईआरटी बुक। ओके, आज जो बताने वाला चीज था इन्फॉर्मेशन कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजी था बताने वाला, वो हम लोग कर लीजिए। ठीक है, जियो थर्मल एनर्जी, जब इसको पढ़ोगे तो ये नाम आपको याद रखना बहुत जरूरी है। मे बी इन फिल्म्स दे कैन आस्क यू क्वेश्चन, हिमालय प्रोविंस, फॉल्टेड बॉल प्रोविंस, इसमें कौन कौन सा जगह पर क्या है लोकेशन है, दैट विल बी, लोकेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ऑफ डिफरेंट एनर्जी इन आवर कंट्री। ठीक है, वेस्ट एनर्जी ये है, दीज आर सातपाणी, छत्तीसगढ़, पुक्कन, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, दीज आर सम इम्पोर्टेंट प्लेसेज शुड नो। सो आई विल अपलोड ऑल दिस फाइल्स, ओके, यू कैन डाउनलोड एंड यू कैन रीड इट। ओके, सो विल मीट यू इन नेक्स्ट क्लास विथ इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक कॉल्ड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी। इज इट ओके टू एवरीबडी? ओके, थैंक यू सो मच।